Welcome to our program, The Famous Asian Entrepreneurs. Today we have with us Mr. Pramod Saxena, who is a pass out from IIT Roorkee and has also received a Distinguished Alumni Award in 2015 from IIT Roorkee.
Mr. Pramod Saxena is now the founder and the chairman of Oxigen Services Private Limited. Sir, I would request you to please share in your journey with us.
I passed out from IIT Roorkee in 1975 and after that joined the DCM Group, which was one of the leading petrochemical fertilizer company at that time, as a management trainee, and spent my first 8-9 years with them. Learning about project management, and I worked very closely with the chairman of the company, Charat Ram, at that time, who was famously known as One Man Management School. I was very fortunate to work very closely with him. After that, I spent about 10 years with SR Group, where I honed my skills in building projects. So I built some significant projects in steel, and then developed the telecom business for them, which was SR cell phone, later on became Hutch SR, and now is Vodafone. So I built that business for SR Group. And right after that, I was with Motorola, led the Motorola business operations for the region, continental India, part of South Asia group, for about 6 years. And around that time, having spent so many years, a couple of decades in business and industry, building businesses, projects, different areas, I felt that I think I should do something of my own. And I started this concept of digital payments. At the time when we started in 2004, I don't think many people even knew about digital payments. And the concept of creating a connected ecosystem for digital payments was not there. So we were kind of pioneer in launching digital payments, but we used channel to the market, which is merchants, where most customers would come for payment. And later on in 2008, we actually launched a mobile wallet at a time when there was not even a smartphone, and data services were very poor and very expensive. At that time, Microsoft Corporation partnered with us, invested in our business, and we continued to grow from there on.
गुरु गोविंद तो खड़े काके लागो पाए बलिहारी गुरु आपने गोविंद दियो बताए कबीरा.
Now coming up with a different module altogether for educational institutions, so can you just tell us a bit more in terms of your contribution towards the education industry onto the same?
Education is perhaps the most important field where the government and the system should focus on, and we have had education which is primarily focused more on students working hard, scoring very high marks in exams. I guess 499 out of 500 and 498. I think that's good, but that's not the vision that a country like ours should have for education. I think we have to prepare children for developing all-round skills, developing their mental faculties in a manner that they can become more creative. They can be part of innovation, because that's something which is really missing. Such brilliant minds we have, as is evident from how the children score in exams, but the way method of education itself and the pressure on the children to perform academically is so much more than their all-round performance. So why I mention this is today the environment and the ecosystem and the technology which provides interactive platform for children to educate in a very different way is very important. And how to create an ecosystem in the schools and right from early stages where children can be interactive, they can be exposed to more creative thinking, which in turn will bring innovation, culture, can be used the platform that is now ubiquitous, which is mobile access, whether it is iPads or iPhones or whatever, can be put to good use. And being in this business, having been associated with telecom industry for long, and now in the space of interactiveness on payments with customers, I personally feel that education institutions can adopt methods that can help them and help their children to benefit from what is available technologically today. So just limiting myself to what we do in Oxigen, our payment environment and the interactive platform that allows people to not just make payments, but also do different things that are part of their day-to-day life in their environment, is what I think needs to be applied to the education, to schools. Now, children going to school are not just paying fees, but they are involved in the ecosystem with teachers, and the schools have different needs that they need to address for the children, whether it's their attendance or their school curriculum, also exam schedules, payments for different things, planning of trips, and giving them exposure to extracurricular activities. Now, all of this can become part of an interactive platform that could be customized for schools, because schools, colleges, institutions, they will have different needs. They have their own designed programs, and no two schools may be doing things in the same way. So the platform that we have for payment can become an interactive platform for schools, customized for those schools or colleges, where not just their academic piece, but also extracurricular piece, their payments and other needs can be addressed. I mean, we are, for example, we're working on this already with some institutions. In addition to this, we are also looking at the possibility of providing financial support to the parents to afford the rising costs of school fees and other associated expenses. Also, children are getting some specialized tuitions, which could be to prepare them for whatever they want to do in life. Now, all of this is putting a heavy burden on the parents. And while there are several hundred million students, and therefore that many or about that many parents, the cost involved is not that easily affordable by most parents, right? Maybe they can afford the cost over a period of time, but as the peaks of these requirements come, it becomes a burden. And today, technology, mobile phone access, the ability to connect on social media, pulling all of this information about how you are, who you are, what you do, how you spend your money, gives an opportunity for technology through algorithms and special techniques to profile an individual and be able to offer them financial support without requiring collaterals, you see. You would not hear banks or organizing systems offering financial support to parents, or to children till they go to very high education. But in this case, it can be done. And again, this is the technology. So if the ecosystem is created for the schools where parents and children and schools can interact, their needs can be understood, and more information can be gathered, then perhaps children can benefit, the schools can benefit from financial assistance made to the children to ensure that their fees are paid in time and they have cash flows are properly taken care. So we're working on those things, and I think As this becomes more popular, as data analytics and technology and mobile platforms start addressing various needs, it can become a big boon for the schools. And we would ourselves like to interface with the schools and talk to them and understand their needs in greater detail so that we can address this in a more comprehensive way.